Hello students, so in the this is the 10th video on first module. In the last video I was explaining about the how the execution of a program takes place. Either it is in a straight line sequencing program or it may be a branching program. So we have two different operations which takes place, that is one is fetch and the other one is the execution process. So I explained you about how the sequencing takes place. Now with the help of example we will see how actually this loop or branch will branch operation will be performed, or how the branch programs will be executed. So here we, in this example, we can see that there is an operation move n comma r1. So here clear r0, so these two are the instructions, and loop, this is the these are the instructions which has to be executed in a loop. So here we have determine address of next number and add next number to r0. So what we have to do is determine address of next number and add next number to r0. So decrement r1, so first how many times we want to add the number, so that has to be stored in n. And move n comma r1, so the register r1, it will be consisting of the number of times the loop has to be executed. Okay, so next is r will be initialized to 0, so that is nothing but clear r0. It indicates that if any other previous data is stored in r0, then that has to be cleared and it has to be made 0. r0 has to be made 0. Okay, then determine the address of the next number and add the next number to r0. So we keep on adding the next number to r0. So each and every time the loop is executed, we have to decrement r1. For example, if we are performing this operation 10 number of times, then r1 will be initiated to 10 first. Then each and every time we are going to decrement the r1 value and branch greater than 0 to loop when, if branch is greater than 0. Okay, move r0 comma sum, so the new r0 value again and again it has to move to the sum. Okay, so here we are performing the branch instruction, so sum n num1 num2 till num n all will be stored here at these address locations. We are fetching them and we are performing these loop operations until and unless branch will be greater than 0. We are going to perform this, and once branch, this condition will becomes false, we will be coming out of this, and at last the whatever will be stored in sum, that will be the end result of the program. Okay, got it? This is how the branch instructions will be executed. Okay, next is condition codes. So the condition codes, the processor keeps track of information about the result of various operations. So this is accomplished by recording the required information in individual bits called as condition code flags. So what it is like, how the status of each and every instruction or operation will be recorded by the processor, and it will be stored in a single bit information storage, like registers. We can tell them as single bit registers, which are used for storing the status of the operation. So these type of registers, they are called as condition code flags. So these flags are grouped together in a special processor register called as a condition code register. Okay, so these are registers, these process registers or the condition code flags, they are grouped together into a special process register, which is called as a condition code register or the status register. So there are four commonly used flags, and they are N, Z, V and C. N, it indicates negative. That is, if it is set to 1, if the result is negative, and if it is set to 0, if the result is positive. Okay, 0, it is set to 1 if the result is 0, otherwise it is set to 0. Right? Otherwise, set to 1 if the result is 0, or else it is set to 0. V represents the overflow. Set to 1 if arithmetic overflow occurs, else it will be set to 0. So all these flags, where it will be used, how it will be used, everything we will be studying in our future modules. okay, mainly in the arithmetic module, where we are going to perform different arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division operations. So there we will be making use of these types of flags, conditional codes. Okay, so last one is carry. Carry is set to 1 if there is a carry out from the operation. So it will be set to 0 if it is if it doesn't consist of a carry out. Okay, so these are about the condition codes and the four different common flags which are used for this condition codes. And these flags together, they are called as condition code register, and they will be stored in the condition code register. Okay, so once we are familiar with what is a straight line sequencing of the program, what is a branch sequencing, and what are the different conditional codes used, then we have to be familiar with what are the different addressing modes used. So how we are going to use the addressing modes in order to fetch the data from the memory. So the different ways in which the location of an operand is specified in an instruction are referred to as addressing modes. So this addressing modes, so here you can see, so register direct, register indirect, address register indirect with index, memory indirect, program counter indirect, program counter indirect with index, program counter memory indirect, absolute data addressing and immediate. So these are the different addressing modes which are used in order to fetch the data from the memory or in order to store the data into the memory. Okay, so we will be seeing one by one. So before moving to the different types of register, different types of addressing modes, we have to see what are the variables and constants, how we are going to differentiate between them. Variables and constants are the simple data types and are found in almost every computer program. So they will be in C language also, we make use of this constant values and the variables in which we are going to different data types like integer data type and a floating point, character, string. So all these are the different data types which are being used. So here also in assembly language, a variable is represented by allocating a register or memory location to hold its value. So thus the value can be changed as needed using the appropriate instruction. So here the variable will be used to store the or to hold the certain values. Okay, so that values, it can be changed based on the appropriate instructions which are being performed in the computer system. Okay, so when you are familiar with this, first we will move to the first addressing mode, that is the register mode. So here in this register mode, the operand is a content of a register. So we will be having operation followed by the operand. So these operands are nothing but the contents of the register. The name or address of the register is given in the instruction. Registers are used as temporary storage locations where the data in a register are accessed. So that is whatever data is stored within the register will be accessed with this register mode. Okay, so for example, the instruction move R1, R2, copy the contents of R1 to the register R2. So this is the register mode where we are making use of two registers to perform an operation move. That is the instruction move has to be performed. How it is performing means the contents of R1 will be moved to the register R2. So here we are making use of two registers only. Hence we are calling this type of instructions are in the register mode. So this is about the register mode. Next, absolute or direct mode. So here we make use of the operand is in a memory location. So the address of memory location is given explicitly in the instruction. For example, the instruction move LOC, R2. So this is the memory location. LOC specifies the memory location. So whatever contents are placed in this LOC will be moved to R2. Copy contents of memory location LOC into register R2. That is the direct mode, or it is called as absolute mode. And this is register mode because we are making use of two registers here. This is the memory mode or absolute mode because we are making use of the memory location and also the register here. So next is the immediate mode. we will see it in the next lecture.